Subscribe this channel by pressing this button for being updated from Biomedical and Healthcare Society.
Hello guys, this is Amit over here and you are watching Techomed. In this video, we're gonna discuss about microprocessors myths. So without any further delay, let's get started.
The very first question that arises in our mind while talking about microprocessor is that, what is microprocessor? Here's the answer for that question. A microprocessor is an integrated circuit which incorporates core functions of a computer's central processing unit. It is a programmable multipurpose silicon chip, clock driven, register based, which accepts binary data as input and provides output after processing it as per the instructions stored in the memory. Now let us discuss about the myths which are being popular in people about the microprocessor. In every single day, we come across many intelligent devices that has a microprocessor embedded in it. People get passionate over processors more than RAM or decoders. Everyone has their own favorite processor which they likely to recommend others and also to use over and over again. And low sounds microprocessor. Some are true, but many are just myths which we believe to be true. The very first myth that I want to discuss is that very few processor choices are available out there, but it's not like that. This is the most subtle misconception while designing an embedded system, that we have a choice of only 10 to 20 32-bit processors. But the fact is that there are 100 different 32-bit processors available for sale. This counting is not irrespective of different packages and speed, but dozens of companies make different CPUs, architecture and instruction sets. The second myth that I want to discuss is that Intel rules the world of the microprocessor. For a lot of people, microprocessor means Intel Pentium. The newspaper proclaimed that Intel has 95% of shares of microprocessor market, but there is all media hypes, nothing true. Intel Pentium has a dominant share of the PC business, but PC contributes to a very small slice of the microprocessor pie. In 98% of the embedded CPUs, Intel is not even in the top. ARM vendors alone sell about 3 times of the Intel sells Pentium. The third myth that I want to discuss is that instruction sets don't matter. Instruction set affect your assembly codes. We go on using instruction as it is meant. We have never thought of instruction sets in this context. Whatever you use, Java or C, C++ or any other language, it is ultimately dumped into the hardware. Performance, predictability and power consumption are heavily dependent on the underlying instruction set. Let us take an example of multiplying two numbers. This is a very easy job and hardly any programmer will worry. But different chips handle multiplication in different ways. Many RISC chips could not even do multiplication. So the early RISC compiler has to synthesize their own integral multiple functions. But it was a fast operation. Now the processor have a built-in multiply instruction, but not all multipliers are the same. Some chips can do multiplies much faster than others, and it has nothing to do with the clock frequency. The fourth myth that I want to discuss is about RISC is better than CISC. Both RISC and CISC have their strength, and neither is better all the time. RISC chip provides more code density, smaller memory footprints and more mature software tools. But RISC chips have higher clock rates, so the selection clearly depends on your application. The fifth myth that I want to discuss is Java chips are coming. Java language was never meant to be handled in hardware. Garbage collection, threads, stack orientation and object management take a megabyte worth of Java virtual machine to translate into something that even the faster computer of today struggle to execute. Decades of computer evolution and research in companies and universities around the world has failed to produce anything like Java machine. But Java accelerator chip are available. It executes 30% to 60% of Java bytes into hardware. The sixth myth that I want to discuss is dry stone MIPS are a useful benchmark. To understand what DMIPS are, you will first have to understand what exactly a dry stone is. Dry stone is a synthetic computing benchmark program which represents the processor performance. The dry stone counts only the program iteration completion per second, while Dry stone is divided by 1757, that is, dry stone million instruction per second. As the instructions are not same from processor to processor, so counting and comparing them is meaningless. For example, a high-level task may require more instruction on RISC machine, but may get executed as a single CISC instruction. The seventh myth that I want to discuss is about ARM consumes slowest power. In the early 90s, the ARM was the one of the first 32-bit processor to be embedded into the ASICs rather than shouldered alongside a separate chip. It was possible because ARM had no cache, no drivers, no outside bus, and not much more an instruction set. But today, there are plenty of 32-bit processors available as ASIC core. They use even less power both in standby or when they are active. The eighth myth that I want to discuss is that higher the performance, higher the price. But it's not like that. Cost is what it requires to build a chip, but price is what marketing department wants it to be. Price is determined by the market forces, and there is no such relation between price and performance.
I hope you guys might have understood what I was trying to convey. If you have any query or suggestion, you can ask me in comment section. I would love to answer your question over there. If you have not subscribed to this channel, you can do it by pressing this button. Do like this video, do share this video. So this is Amit Monaman signing out. Jai Hind.